Welcome to this video. I'm glad to show you a new feature we implemented in RelicsCAD for Revit to help you do your lighting design inside of Revit, and this even faster and more efficient than ever. My name is Matthias Wiss. I'm working as a software developer at Relux. But first, let's have a look at the history of RelicsCAD for Revit. In 2016, we started with creating content for Revit, basically by converting all the Lumineers from our database to Revit family files. In the following year, we released the first version of RelicsCAD for Revit with helpful tools to use these Lumineers in an efficient way in the Revit model, for example, with the zonal cavity tool. 1 year later, we released the interface to Relux Desktop, where you had the possibility to export your Revit model to Relux Desktop, do your lighting design in Relux Desktop, and re-import Lumineers to Revit. This way, you could save a lot of time since you no longer had to remodel your building in Relux Desktop. But the goal was always to not have to switch between different softwares. And in 2021, we brought the Relux calculation core into Revit. And since then, it's possible to do radiosity calculations directly in Revit for interior and exterior scenes. This year, we made a few very important improvements in RelicsCAD for Revit. First of all, the performance update, which made it possible to work with huge projects, which you often have in Revit. Then we added new standard EN12464, as well as US best practice, and did huge improvement to the EasyLooks tool, which I'm going to show you later. And it's also possible now to draw your custom task areas, which no longer depend on a face in the Revit model. We added new calculation settings in the plugin. And last but not least, it's now possible to work with SenseNorm sensors inside of Revit. Let's have a look how these features look in Revit. First, we're gonna have a look at the new standards we added to RelicsCAD for Revit, and we do this in the room manager, where we can work on all the rooms in the building at once. For example, we look for all the instruction rooms, select them, and assign a usage profile. Here we have all the standards available in RelicsCAD for Revit. The new EN12464, the US best practice, and the older standards. But for now, we're going to use the European standard. Select a profile, for example, for the conference rooms. And now we have to decide whether we want to use lower values, higher, or select the intermediate standards. Here we can add a reason for our decision by selecting one of the list, or just type in our custom reason here. Then we have to select a luminaire for our basic lighting. Select one and start the calculation process. Now the needed amount of luminaires will be placed automatically in the room, and a radiosity calculation will be performed afterwards, and shortly we see the results in the room manager as well. And we can check whether we reached the standard or not. In the plan view, we can display the false colors from results from the calculation. In the ceiling plan, we see the placed luminaires. Now let's have a look at the improvements of the EasyLux tool. If we want to calculate a single room, simply select it in the Revit model and access the EasyLux tool. We see the new arrangement types here on the top, at the top of the dialog, and we also see if we already have a ceiling grid in the Revit model. It gets displayed here in the preview, and we can automatically arrange the luminaires to fit to this ceiling grid. When we apply the luminaires to the model, we see that the luminaires perfectly fit to the ceiling grid here. Another important improvement is if we have a differently rotated room, like the one we see here. And again, access the EasyLux tool. And now the plugin automatically aligns the longest wall to the x-axis. This was the view we would have seen before. And we can also select the wall in the preview we want to align to the x-axis. After applying the luminaires to the model, we see that luminaires are rotated correctly. Now let's move on to the task areas. If we, for example, want to do a detailed calculation in a room, for example, here we have a table where want to add a task area, can select the pick face tool, select the top face of the table, and a calculation area or task area is automatically added to this table. If you don't have a face to pick, you can use the new draw tool for task areas. We select a drawing option in the ribbon, for example, the rectangle. We can also draw closed polylines, circles, and so on. After finishing, we get a task area on the wall. And you can now start the calculation for this room. And see the results on the task areas. For exterior scenes, we also did a few improvements, which I'm going to show you now. We now have the option in the export to only export the visible elements in the active view. So, for example, we can use the section box to hide elements we're not interested in. Or we can use the visibility graphics override to hide categories or just single elements and then export. The project. Make sure that the option is active here and export it to Relox Desktop. This way we get way smaller projects in Relox Desktop, which make it way easier to work with. And you can also create some interesting views like sections or cuts through buildings. Now we have the same option for calculations inside of Revit. You can access the new calculation setting dialog located beneath the calculation button. And here we can also check to only use the visible elements and now we're gonna add some luminaires here on the wall. Again, create a task area with the new draw tool. Add the task area here. This is also very important, a very important feature when you, for example, work with linked models, because you no longer have to have pickable faces in your model. Then we start the calculation. And now this works way faster than before, because you no longer have to always calculate the complete building for an exterior scene. And check the results on the task area. We can also access the calculation results for all the for the complete building in a schedule where all the task areas are listed with their calculation results. Those were new features we already implemented, but there is a lot to come. The two main points on our schedule are the emergency lighting calculation in Revit and the integration of the Relox Automizer in the plugin. This version I just showed is available on relox.com as well as the Autodesk App Store. And if you already installed an earlier version of Relox Cut for Revit, you should get a notification on the startup of Revit. Thanks a lot for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it.